the last one standing. Two hands in the air, I'm a champion. You'll be looking up at me when it's over. I live for the battle, I'm a soldier. Yeah, I'm a fighter like Rocky. Put your flat on your back like Ali. I'm the greatest, I'm stronger. Pay my dues, can't lose, I'm a owner. Yeah, yeah. Been working my whole life.
Good morning, students and all present here. Welcome to the CCA Assembly. This year, though we do not have the opportunity to allow the outside providers to come into school and conduct various activities, but I am very proud to announce that our senior students came forward and taken up the initiative to run the student-led program at school. Now, we have almost 23 student-led clubs running at present. Due to the large numbers, we have divided CCA Assembly into two. So today is the first one. I once again welcome you all. I hope you will enjoy the various presentations.
I like to debate because in debates I have the liberty to speak the truth and what's on my mind. In debates, I get to see both sides of the situation and not just one.
I debate because of the skills you develop. My thinking has become more structured and organized, and I'm able to turn my ideas into arguments and present them in a constructed manner. My speech-giving skills are improving, and I'm more confident about public speaking with each debate I take part in. Lastly, I'm starting to work better and more efficiently in teams with other people. My communication skills are improving, and I'm learning how to get my point across.
I debate because I love engaging in new topics, whether in foreign affairs or nutrition, and learning more through balanced discussions with the debate community. By discovering new perspectives and learning more about varied issues across the globe, I grow into a better and hopefully more knowledgeable person.
I debate to better understand issues that affect both me and the global community in a more objective and logical manner.
In Debate Club, we look at things in different perspectives. Out of the many activities we engage in within this enthusiastic club, here are a few things we do. First, we watch debates to learn and build on our key debating skills. Second, we apply these skills as we work together in groups, also developing leadership skills and teamwork.
Three, we build our confidence as each of us gets time to express our opinions. Four, we get masterclasses for debating where we learn valuable experience along with tips and tricks on debating. Five, finally, we get to interact with students with similar interests as we broaden our knowledge.
We, as a school, have still managed lots of achievements during this pandemic. Here are just the few we shall announce today.
BEHAS is a nationwide debate tournament that spans 4,000 students and 22 cities. In BEHAS 5.0, Hansika Gupta got the 19th Best Speaker Award. Harshika Hundal got the 17th Best Speaker Award. Tvisha Nair got the 16th Best Speaker Award. Arith Tapadia got the 13th Best Speaker Award. And Advait Ramanujan got the 5th Best Speaker Award. In the Lions division, Tamana Nambiar got the 14th Best Speaker Award and Disha Sarogi got the 3rd Best Speaker Award. In 8.0, Advait Ramanujan got the 6th Best Speaker Award and Arith Tapadia got the 14th Best Speaker Award. Please give a round of applause for these people.
The Aditya Parliamentary Debate is a national tournament with 127 debaters. All four teams with TISB students in them performed extremely well. Advika Amira Sadasivan reached the quarterfinals and placed as one of the top 10 speakers. Ananya's team won the tournament, and the other two teams comprised of Avi Konduri, Shreya Tota, Aryan Agarwal, Vyom Kumar, Aditya Gupta, and Sahithi Bolsu.
Hi, and good morning to all present today. Creative and critical thinking skills are widely required and applied in solving problems in the world, from trying to simple things like fit all your luggage in the back of a car, to doing more complex things like constructing buildings and trying to land rovers on Mars. Let's look at a real-life scenario and see if you can find a solution to the problem. Imagine you've been selected to appear in the game show, Ferrari or Goat, and have the chance to either drive away in a shiny new car or walk away with just a goat. There are three doors, behind two of which are goats, and behind one is a sports car. You are asked to choose one of the three doors. The host will then open one of the other two doors that has a goat behind it. You now have the opportunity to stick with your original choice or switch to the other remaining door, and you will receive whatever is behind the door that you choose. So should you switch or should you stay with your original decision?
Now at first sight, this seems like a very simple and basic problem. Almost everyone thinks that there's no advantage of switching to a new door. We presume that surely all the doors must have the same probability of being selected. Despite this general belief, there is a way for you to optimize your chance of winning. To do this, you should always switch doors. Since there is a 1/3 chance that the door you picked has a car, there is a 2/3 chance that one of the other two doors has the car. And because one door is open, revealing a goat, the whole 2/3 chance is placed on the other door. Because 1/3 is less than 2/3, you should switch doors every time. This does not ensure you winning for this round, but will help your odds in the long run.
Now let's look at what would happen if we changed the problem a little bit. Let's assume the rules to be identical to the original question, with two exceptions. Firstly, the host allows you to pick two doors and not one. And second, instead of revealing the goat from a door you didn't choose, they reveal a goat from a door you did choose. Now, if he allows you to switch, would you do so or would you stay with your original choice? The answer is to stay. The two doors you picked have a 2x3 chance of having a car, and when one of the doors is opened, this 2x3 probability is placed on the other door that you initially chose. Thus, your best bet is to stay with the original door.
What we have just explored is known as the Monty Hall problem, a famous brain teaser that loosely stems from a game show, Let's Make a Deal. Though this problem seems quite simple, it has sparked endless debate in the mathematics community, but in the end, the solution above elegantly describes the math behind this problem and can be used to solve similar ones as well.
Logical and critical thinking skills, along with mathematics, are a necessity in today's world. At the Creative and Critical Thinking Maths Club, we explore such problems in great depth. And if you want to enhance these skills further, we'd encourage you to join the club that takes place every Wednesday after school. Thank you for watching.
Hey, Vsauce, Michael here.
Wait, that's not history.
Hey, TISB, Ayush, head of the history club. History, what is it to most people? Mundane? Boring, even? Not the members of our club. Here are the members of our club telling you a little bit about their most interesting facts and a few things that they find funny about the course of history.
Hello, my name is Avi Kanduri, and today I will be sharing with you two interesting facts from history. The first is that Cleopatra's reign was closer to the moon landings than the Great Pyramids being built. The Egyptian royal reigned from 51 BC to 30 BC, roughly 2,500 years after the Great Pyramids of Giza was built and roughly 2,000 years before the first lunar landings took place in 1969. The second interesting fact from history I would like to share is that in 46 BC, during the triumph of Caesar, the Colosseum was flooded and a miniaturized naval battle took place.
Emperor Qin Shi Huang of China escaped from an assassin by running around a pillar. The assassin attempted to stab the emperor using a knife he'd concealed in a map. As none of the officials in the room were armed and as the emperor himself was unable to unsheathe his ceremonial sword, he had to run around a pillar to escape from his assassin. Eventually, the emperor's physician threw his medical bag at the assassin, buying the emperor precious time to unsheathe his sword and mortally wound his assassin, escaping with his life.
The award of the strangest death of a US president goes to Zachary Taylor, who died in 1950. After attending 4th of July orations for most of the day, Taylor walked along the Potomac River before returning to the White House. Hot and tired, he drank iced water and consumed large quantities of cherries and other fruits. The president suffered severe stomach pains for the next 5 days. Diagnosed as suffering from cholera morbus by his physician, Taylor ate slivers of ice until his body began rejecting fluids. And then he died. So yes, it is possible to die from eating cherries.
Did you know that the fastest surgeon ever ended up causing a 300% mortality rate? Pretty shocking, right? Surgeon Robert Liston was considered the fastest knife in the West and a pioneer in speed surgery. When performing a battlefield amputation in front of a group of spectators, Liston cut through his patient's leg so quickly that he accidentally cut off the fingers of the person who was helping him. One man who witnessed the surgery collapsed and died of a heart attack. Then Liston's patient and his assistant died of blood poisoning from their joint amputation, making him the only surgeon in history to have a 300% mortality rate.
Thank you for watching the History Club CCA Assembly. We hope you enjoyed, and if you did enjoy, consider joining the History Club. We meet every Thursday and it's extremely fun. See you there.
So hey everyone, we're the Economics Club and Economics, and today we thought we'd tell you a little bit about, you know, what we're doing at these two organizations and our plans for the future. So let's, without further ado, let's move on to the Economics Club. So, you know, as you can see, at the Economics Club, we meet every Friday. And, you know, what do we do every Friday? Well, we seek to discuss, you know, current affairs on economics and on finance. And, you know, it really is a sort of very open-ended, you know, interactive sort of place for people that are passionate about economics and finance to voice their opinions on various issues that they think are important. And then, you know, to sort of, you know, exchange ideas and things like this and brush up on, you know, economics fundamentals and then maybe expand into more advanced topics. And, you know, now I'll hand over to Kush, who will tell you a little bit more about the structure of our sessions and what we actually do in a little more detail.
In the club, we take up interesting economic concepts like game theory or issues like the national budget, and help students understand using fun activities like mock auctions and games like Spit or Steal. I'll now be handing over to Badri, who will talk about the activities the club plans in the future.
We plan on making the activities as interesting as possible and as interactive as possible. And we'll be having a lot of Kahoot quizzes, group discussions and debates, which makes the concept interesting. And in the future, I hope to see you all there in the club and have good interactive sessions with you. Now I'll be handing it over to the Economics Magazine.
So the Economics Magazine is a publication by the students of TISB. It started out by seniors and we continue the legacy. We accept articles from anyone and everyone, and the magazine comprises of edifice articles, especially written by students. The theme of this year's issue is presidency and leadership. I'll be handing over to Song Jun Kang, who will be talking about why you should submit for the economics.
So why should you be involved in economics? The Economics Magazine helps students enhance their economic knowledge by applying theories to real-life examples, henceforth allowing them to realize the impact of economics. As a student-led magazine, Economics prioritizes student perspectives by providing the students with an opportunity to share and empower their unique economic and judgmental insights through their articles. Finally, by enabling students to become aware of the economic affairs of the world, the Economics Magazine encourages the youth to take significant roles in making a change in the contemporary world. Now I'll be handing over to Ameya, who will talk about the Economics Magazine's future releases.
The February issue of our magazine revolves around the theme of presidency and leadership, a theme that focuses on how leadership can influence the economic decisions implemented around the world. The issue hopes to provide an insight into how governance and regulation can be used as a medium to boost the level of economic activity in every country. It sets forth a platform for young leaders to voice their opinions in matters that concern the functioning and growth of each and every economy in the world. Thank you.
Yeah, if you guys have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out to us on one of the emails that you see before you right now. And that's all from us. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Anish and I run the Origami Club with Amok, and I teach regular 2D origami. Over the past year, we have built numerous origami structures, starting from a simple paper boat and a paper plane or a paper rocket to much more complicated ones, such as a samurai hat, a whale, a cat, a dog, a turtle, and the list goes on and on. We did face some troubles in the start since it was online classes, but we got adjusted to it, and we both think that we did a great job. We are very proud of the standards the students achieved and hope that the Origami Club will flourish in the future as well. Thank you.
Hi everyone, I'm Amok, and as Anish mentioned, we run the TISB Origami Club together. I teach 3D origami, and for the past year we started from the basics. We first learned how to make 3D origami pieces and then learned how to make a 3D origami base. On top of that, we started on slightly simpler models such as a swan and a flower. After that, we progressed on to slightly complex ones such as a penguin, and now we're going to learn to make a peacock as well. As Anish mentioned, it's been slightly challenging to teach online over Microsoft Teams. We feel like we adjusted quite well, and we were thrilled with the enthusiasm that all the students showed. And we hope that we'll continue running Origami Club in the future as well. And here are a few pictures of the 3D origami models that our students have made. Thank you.
What is light? To answer that question, we're going to need to go into a lot of physics. That'll lead to more questions, some of which we don't even know the answers to.
But what we can say is that light is made up of photons. And just like photons illuminate our lives, we at the Photon Club seek to shed some light on the incandescent world of physics.
The Photon Club is the place to go to discuss the wackiest and coolest concepts in physics. If you think physics isn't fun or is boring, we'll make you think twice.
We've discussed everything from the mind-bending quantum world where physics defies all intuition, to the macroscopic universe where the unknown outweighs the known.
Physics doesn't just answer questions, it gives us so many new ones. And what better way to subvert the idea of questions and answers than Jeopardy?
We started off this term's theme of time with a fun quiz, asking questions like, what is the bootstrap paradox, or what is time?
Now to the ultimate question. What is the answer to life, the universe, and everything?
The answer is 42. What is the question?
We also talked about things like the latest technology, discoveries, interesting phenomena of astrophysics,
sci-fi books and movies, and what they got right and wrong, an on-the-spot physics crisis, and puzzling what-if thought experiments.
We also discussed several time travel paradoxes, things you've probably seen in Back to the Future, but with a scientific perspective.
Want to know what it's really like? Here's what some of our members have to say.
What I've learned so far from the Photon Club are curiosity, exploration, and determination. Thank you.
Photon is one of my strongest connections to physics today, and it's a place where I can actually talk about my love for the subject with people who are just as passionate about it.
Energy is everything.
The Photon Club enables us to explore concepts in physics in unconventional ways, making each and every session incredibly fun to attend.
We also run the Photon Magazine, our school's very own physics publication, which allows students to share their knowledge and discuss interesting perspectives.
We publish an issue every term, and our first issue, themed Space, was released on 9th November. It included several great articles about the end of the universe, the expansion of the universe, space elevators, and even black hole theories.
Our next issue, themed Time, is coming out soon, so keep an eye out for our emails whether you'd like to contribute or just read our final issue.
We have sessions every Monday from 3:30 to 4:30, and we would love to see more of you join us. Until then, may the force be with you.
This year, as you know, most of the inter-house events were conducted online, such as burpee jump competition, inter-house debate, inter-house science exhibition, inter-house magazine competition, inter-house shark tank competition, kilometers for COVID, inter-house MUN, which is still going on, and inter-house essay writing competition. Now, most of the above events results has been announced in your house meeting last week. Now, I have the results of inter-house essay writing competition. And the results are, in juniors category, first place goes to Sharanya Saxena of Discoverers. Second place goes to Voyagers, K.R. Mehra. Third place goes to Verushka Pandey of Voyagers again. We have two special mentions, Kundavi Sudhan of Discoverers and Anaya Singhania of Explorers. Moving on to the seniors category, in first place we have Seungjun Kang of Explorers. Second place goes to Neha Talla of Pioneers. And third place goes to Prashant Lohia of Pioneers once again. Two more special mention, Anya Palam Reddy from Pioneers and Vivek Singh from Discoverers. Now moving on including the essay writing competition scores and the Shark Tank scores. As of now, the overall point that stands is like this. In fourth place, we have with 77.5 points, Voyagers. In third place, we have with 85 points, Explorers. Second place with 90 points, Pioneers. And in first place, we have Discoverers with 102.5 points. TISB P department, for the first time ever, conducted virtual Trojans Cup, an inter-school sports event. In this event, 8 schools participated in 4 disciplines: basketball, football, hockey, and yoga. Players were tested in 2 skill components and 1 fitness component. We had conducted in 2 categories, under 16 and under 18, boys and girls, was held on 15th February, and some of our TISB students have made us all so very proud by achieving merit certificates. The results are, in under 16 boys basketball, first place Vedant Dashore, and in second place we also had a TISB student, Sohan Tarigopala. In football, under 16 boys, first place Akshit Jain, second place Ayush Kupanda. In under 18 boys, we had Shaunak Handa from TISB receiving the merit certificates in football. Moving on to hockey, in under 16 girls, we have in third place 2 TISB students, Leah Sharif and Eloise DeVos. Under 16 boys category hockey, first place goes to Harshit Gowda, and second place we have Nipun Agrawal from TISB. Moving on to under 12 and under 14 category, which was held on the 24th of February. In basketball, under 14 boys, we have Aditya Venkatesh achieving the first position, and we have Arav Modi of TISB achieving the second position. In under 14 girls basketball, we have in third place Xenia Irani. Moving on to football, in under 14 boys, Aryan Kocher from TISB achieved the first position. And in yoga, under 12 girls, we have Demira Rajkumar receiving the first position. Thank you. As you can see, the art exhibition is up and running. Now I have with me the art prefect, Chanmin. Please come in, Chanmin.
Hello, welcome to art exhibition. All the students are welcome to come and have a look. But if you are unable to, or you want to see the whole process of the art exhibition, then keep your eyes up for the documentary online.